Okay, hi everyone. This is Shankar Raj Subramanian here. Glad to meet you in BikeCon. To introduce myself, my name is Shankar Raj Subramanian. I have 15 years of experience in this domain. I've worked with different government agencies. I'm working closely with cybercrime department in solving cases. I've worked with corporates in providing pen testing solutions, and I've traveled to 45 countries till now. I've met a lot of corporates abroad, students abroad, and I'm glad to meet you all here again. And I hope we can start with the session for today. So today's topic is about cybersecurity challenges and job opportunities. So rather than going too much of technical into this, I wanted to take this in a different perspective of how a job seeker can make use of this, and how corporates, any working professionals like security professionals, how they can make use of the aspects here. And we also have a few things which can be discussed based on the current cybersecurity attacks and a lot of different challenges faced by people who wanted to enter into this domain and people who are already in this domain facing a lot of challenges. Fine. So we'll take it further. And to start with, yes, imagine we have a person who is who has a target or who is looking for a job. Say we'll search for someone from something from a we'll search for okay we'll go for this we'll go to Naukri and we'll search for Vodafone. Okay, we'll go for Vodafone network security. Right, I'm searching for Vodafone network security, and if I search, yes, we have direct tax, this Microland, okay, Dimension Data Private Limited. We can take any one. Okay, we'll take this security L3 consultant Mumbai location. We'll go for this. And if you see this, they require, yes, it's a high profile. It's a mid to senior level kind of profile, which is being displayed here. So in case if a person who is applying for this job or any fresher kind of job, probably the interview point of view, that's the most mostly asked question in all social media. In case if you're attending interviews, what should I do? How should I get prepared? Right. So you are a person who is attending interview, or we'll take it as X as a person who is either looking for interviews, want to make a career in this domain, or we'll look him as an attacker who is grabbing information, who is enumerating information, right? So probably in case if you're attending interviews and you're wondering what type of interview questions you have, you can perform a basic enumeration of this company. Our company here is Dimension Data Private Limited. So it is DD India Private Limited. Fine. So you can perform a basic enumeration. You can perform a simple scan, not a massive scan. Don't bring their network down. Simple scan. Why are you doing this? Because you are trying to understand what technologies are used by the company. Fine. What technologies are used? Why do you need to understand the technology is being used? Fine. You are applying for a security analyst role, and probably the questions will be from that point of view. And technologies, you'll need to find out what server they are using, right? You need to find out if they are using a load balancer or not. You need to find out if they're using a firewall. You need to find out if they're using IDS, IPS, or in case if it is networking, probably you should know what series of routers they are using and what switches they are using. And how do we find this? Yes, from this job portal, what we have seen here, in case if you're going to be deployed, or DDA is going to recruit for their own concern and not for their clients, getting all these information can help you a lot, right? So server, yes, they are using IIS, Microsoft server, load balancer, probably AFI load balancer, firewall, they are using a Cisco ASF firewall, IDS, IPS, there is nothing. And routers, yes, they are using Cisco based routers, right? in case if this is the information what you have grabbed for the, from an interview point of view, you should be learning Server 2016. You should be learning about load balancers like FI. You should be learning about ASA firewalls and Cisco routers, basic configuration, right? Your interview point of view, the questions will be based on this. A company which is using IaaS, they are not going to ask you any questions apart from IaaS, because I have IaaS in my company and probably I'm recruiting a security analyst to secure my network infrastructure. So I'll be needing a person who has good experience or good knowledge with Microsoft servers. Right. I have FI load balancer in my infrastructure. So I might be needing someone who has good experience with that. So this is how, and this is how normally, in case if you're looking out for a carrier, you can look for enumerating information. And in case of an attacker, probably he might be looking at what technologies are being used. Why? Because only with this, he can perform a vulnerability analysis and later exploit the total infrastructure. Right. So when seeing this, they have, okay, Cisco, they have, okay, operational knowledge of trunking protocols, BTP, great, and network monitoring management tools analysis. They have not mentioned what tools they need exactly. And when you look at this, yes, they need experience with FI, Arista and McAfee and Checkpoint, fine. We have a lot of things here. So now we'll target FI, fine. In case if they are using FI load balancer, fine. What you can do? Initially, yes, we have different modes. We have different places from where you can enumerate information. The very basic and which is the most commonly used is Google. And then we'll move on to Shodan. This time we'll see Shodan from a different point of view. Google and Shodan. So what I can do, so first I'll be looking at what FI is, what kind of policies are there, or to start with, I'll be looking at, in case if an organization like DDI is, has implemented FI, so what will be the key terms with regards to FI. So what do you mean by key terms here? Fine. Only with the help of these key terms, you will be able to make a proper enumeration. You will be able to get exact details what you need. So FI, it can be with my.policy. These are the most common keywords which you can look, or it can be with my.logout, login. And this keywords can be present in the URL in case if you're looking out for FI load balancers, in case if the companies are implemented. So in case generally, if I want to look which companies have opted for FI load balancers, let me go to Google and let me search for this. I'll type in URL, which is a common Google doc which is used, and I'll search /my.policy, and let me give big IP. Right? So I'm giving a Google doc search like this and enter. So when I enter, see here, I get a lot of clients who are using FI. So I have this. Yes, you have a lot of clients like this. You can open any of this, Starbucks, my policy. When you're looking for Starbucks authentication file, okay, great. We'll look for this. Connection is not private. We get error code of this. So it says the big IP cannot find the session information. So it's pretty obvious they are using, they have implemented big IP here. A logout page. And yes, session could not be established. Big IP cannot find the session information. Or I can go for another Google doc like what I have mentioned here. I'll go in URL. I'll give my.logout.php3? Right. Okay. In URL, this is my.logout.php3. Again, I get the logout page of big IP, big IP, big IP. Right. This is with this. And in case if I'm looking for Shodan, Shodan, Ayu, from attacker's point of view, in case if he is looking for targets matching his criteria, probably I'll be going for this and for Shodan. And Shodan, yes, we can give big IP in general. I'll give big IP enter to check out if I have any big IPs here. Yes, yes, on country based and a lot of categories based on big IP server here. Fine. And one best option would be for you guys to go to use Shodan in command line. So I have my Kali Linux here. Let me open this root. Okay. Kali Linux. And probably when you go for this, when you look at, in case if you're looking for a command line version of this, I can give, okay, let me maximize this. I hope this is good now. Okay. I'll type Shodan. Okay, it's not found, and we'll go for installing this pip install Shodan. Okay, I hope this is installed. Yes. So Shodan is installed now. Let me search for basic things like, okay, I'll check if Shodan is installed. Yes, it is installed here. So I'll also log into my Shodan account here to get the API key. Shodan.io, enter. Okay. Shankar, 1, 2, 3, 4. Save. Okay, I'm in my account and I'll go to developers. I need the API key to install this. So install CLI and get your API key. You can also find this in your my account. So I'll copy this. So after you copy, let me give this API key here. So I'll type Shodan. Init, I'm going to initialize this. Okay, initialize this and paste this here. Fine, enter. Yes, successfully initialized. Now, let me go for a basic search here. I'll type Shodan, and I want to find the count of big IPs here. So I'll give Shodan big IP. I want to see how many devices are there in total. So Shodan is going to give me the count of the big IP devices, what I have here. Yes, I have in total, I have these many devices. Now, in case if I want to check a particular host, say I have a particular host, which goes by this. I want to get some information about this host, about this IP address, right? So I type host and enter. So I get information about this IP address. What this is, from which location, which ports are open, and what kind of server they are using. And in case if you're worried about when attackers, or when you're searching for anything in the internet, you're worried about honeypots, you can use this honeyscore, and you can give the IP address. I'll give the same IP address to check if it is a honeypot or not. In case if it's a honeypot, Shodan is going to give you details about that. So honeyscore. Nope. Great. So after this, after learning about the key terms, what you have here, then the second thing is it is good for you guys to know about the protocols and port numbers. So protocols and port numbers, see, it is a domain-based learning what you're doing here. We are targeting one domain. We are targeting one technology here, and we are updating ourselves with the key terms, the protocols and port numbers, what is being used. So port numbers, yes, FI, they have this port number, and they have 4553, which is used by iQuery. And iQuery is an FI Networks UDP based protocol, which is used for collecting configuration information and configuration details. So I might be looking for these two protocols. I mean, my interest will be in these two protocols. Let me see if there are any ports which are open so I can use this. I'll type shodan count port. Port is 1028, enter. Let me see how many ports are open. Yes, I have 14,319 ports which are open. Let me go for the other port. I'll give 4353. Yes, enter. And yes, I have only four ports. In case if you want to grab details about these ports, yes, I can further go for grabbing details. And shodan, yes, in case if we have a commercial edition of Java paid version, yes, it is going to give you the statistics, live statistics. You can create alerts. You can do a lot of wonderful things with shodan. And yes, it is the most scariest search engines. And it can show you a lot of live devices which are online. Fine. So once if I'm done with this, even if I'm an attacker or a person looking for job opportunities, the next thing, what I'll be concerned or from my interview point of view, the interviewer is going to shoot me questions with vulnerabilities. Right? He's going to ask me a lot of vulnerabilities which already exist. And you're targeting a particular domain. Yes, this is number one. This is number two. Then number three is vulnerabilities. When it comes to vulnerabilities, you will have to look at CVE. You have to be updated with the CVE. You will have to know which is the recent CVE here. CVE general notion goes like this. It's like 2018 and -, it is 213, fine, which says this is the year 2018 and the reference number is 213. So probably we should be looking for FI. Yes, perfect. And in this FI, we should be looking at CVEs from 2020. Check if you have any CVEs from in this year, and probably that can be a recent CVE here. So let me go here. I'll go to Google. I'll search here big IP FI vulnerabilities. And vulnerabilities, enter. And yes, you have this CVE here, which is 2020, which is like 6 months back. So we have got one CVE here. So the knowledge of this CVE will be important for you when you're speaking, when you're making a meaningful conversation in an interview. Right? You might speak of the vulnerabilities here. You can mention the CVE number. You can mention whatever CVE numbers you have in mind. The more number of CVE details, information you have, yes, the more knowledgeable you are. And for an attacker, yes, probably he will for sure use this particular vulnerability for systems which have not upgraded, and he is going to exploit this. And this particular vulnerability is for remote code execution. Right? You can execute your codes remotely, and you can compromise the server to get what you need. Fine, complete system compromise, and yes, probably it is going to give you a lot of details from the server. Fine, for the vulnerable servers. So once if you have found this, okay, we have got the CVE 2020, fine, I'll copy this. Now, the next for exploitation, don't go for Google and search what do we have for exploitation. You might get a lot of results, but we'll go for GitHub. We'll go for GitHub and we'll search what type of vulnerabilities or what exploits do we actually have there. So I'll go to GitHub and let me give this CVE number here, enter, and let me check what we have here. Yes, we have 54 repositories here for this particular CVE. Few might be informational, few will be a proof of concept, and few will have an automated script which can get you somewhere. We'll go for this Chinese. We have FI here, FI, and we have a .py file here. So we have the script here, and what does it do? Okay, let me go back. Let me scroll down. Yes, we have this here. And we'll look at the image. Okay, so this can be a vulnerability assessment tool in case if you are looking out for information from this. Okay, so it goes like this: PC Python 3 CVE file.py, give your target URL. Has blurred it, and in case if your target URL is vulnerable, in case if it is vulnerable, it is going to shed out a lot of information like this, right? So you will have to, as I told you, you will have to first understand the domain, and after you understand this domain, after you understand this, probably make sure you understand what key terms are there. I've stopped with this. We have so many key terms. We have so many things to learn with regards to FI. My best suggestion would be to, in case if you are going for a particular technology, first install this technology. You have to install this. You have to configure this. You have to use this, and you have to provide a service with that technology to your client. Fine. Once if you have done all this, fine. Technically, you will know what is happening in the background. So after getting all these knowledge, then in case if you're targeting for exploitation, or if you're going for bug hunting, or you want to add this skill set to your resume, yes, that is perfectly fine. And it is, that makes some sense, right? And before going to exploitation, I would also suggest you to practice with the labs. So labs, they can give you a pretty much good knowledge of how exploitation happens. Right. After this, not actual exploitation, it's like for bug hunting or for, submitting a POC. Yes, you can go for exploitations like this. Right. So this is a common scenario of what is happening and how you should proceed. And when it comes to job opportunities, we have a lot of job opportunities, and it is the reports. Report suggests we will have 3 million jobs in 2021. And you might be wondering, during this COVID, do we have this much jobs which is actually open? Yes, we have a lot of jobs. The main misconception with the job opportunity is what is being present here. I'll tell you what happens. We have this person X who has he is ready for the job, and say he has completed CEH, EC Council, UK Council. We have N number of councils. Anywhere he has completed CEH. For your understanding, this exam, in case if you are able to go through the dumps, yes, probably you will be able to clear all the MCQs. That is perfectly fine. But he is certified, and when with a common misconception of, if you are being certified, companies will obviously, they will hire you. Fine. If you think that, then you might be wrong. Fine. Any company who is going to hire for a security position. Fine. First, you need to understand what domains you have. In case if it's a company, what all domains you have, and as a fresher or experienced, you fit under which domain. Fine. And probably for an interview, you will have a crowd of, say, for example, 50 people. So 50 people who has completed CES are appearing for this interview, right? And that should be some difference, which you should be standing apart from all these 50 people to get the job offer. So what are the things which you need, which you will be needing as a fresher to crack this interview? First, understand the domains and understand the company, right? Understand the company. Job opportunities can be for a programmer. It is not that if you're a CEH, you have to be a programmer. It can be for a programmer. It can be for a non-programmer. Right? So understand the designations first. What kind of jobs, in case if you're skilled with programming, you say programming is my area of interest, then you'll have to know what all domains I have. Right? And if you say programming is not my choice, I'm literally scared of programming. I can understand programming, but if you ask me to develop something, no, I'm not the guy. If you're that type of person who is a non-programmer, Then you also have a lot of different domains here. We'll see what type of domains we have. And in general, I've been repeating this to a lot of people. In general, before appearing for this exam, before appearing for CEH or any type of certification, number one, probably you will be needing a basic understanding of networks. So networks is the base for a programmer or a non-programmer that helps you in a lot of different place, right? This helps you in understanding what a IP address is, what a router is, what a switch is, what a firewall is, right? Yes, in hacking, you will be learning a lot of things, how to bypass a firewall, how to bypass a router configuration, a lot of things. Yes, but you first need to understand what is a firewall. You should have configured at least one type of firewall so that you will know what an inbound rule is, what an outbound rule is, what is ACL in a firewall. You will understand a lot of different concepts that will come only with networking, right? Networking can give you that knowledge. Once, if you're done with networking, you are good with networking, step number two, go for servers. Fine. Learn about server operating systems. Yes, it is very obvious you will have to learn about one of Microsoft server operating systems, be it 2016 or any version of Microsoft and Linux. Yes, we have a lot of servers. And when you visit any website, and when you look at this, when you look at this, you see a word called Apache. You have a word called Apache and you have a operating system called CentOS. Yes. Knowing these names is okay. But where you can really get skilled, you should be knowing what an Apache server is, how to configure this, what is WordPress, how do I use WordPress to configure a website, and what is Nginx. Fine. You will have to at least be familiar with a lot of different operating systems with regards to servers. If you do that, if you have configured and if you have seen what is good and bad, say probably you will be knowing what folders are important for an Apache and what folders, someone says WP admin, you will be knowing what is the meaning. Without any base knowledge, if you go directly for hunting, if you don't go directly for exploitation, probably you might not be understanding what is the use of this particular folder. Or in simple terms, in case if you see a folder called HT access, right? People who are familiar with Google Docs, yes, they know HT access is an important folder, but what is this folder? Have you ever seen this folder? The answer is no. You should get practiced. You should configure a few things with HT access. HT access is a folder where you place all sensitive information. It's a folder in your, it's a directory in your server. And we have HT password. You have n number of keywords like this, and you will get familiar with all these keywords only when you learn, when you try to configure, and when you try to provide a service with your configured server. Fine. So the next thing is servers, and yes, in servers you might be also be learning about cloud-based architecture. What is important, and yes, database server. You will learn about SQL servers. And there are a lot of different things which you have to learn. Yes, we all have heard this term called SQL injection. SQL injection, perfect. Yes, anyone who is familiar with hacking, he should have heard this term called SQL injection. But my suggestion is that you should have a website. I don't have place here. Okay, let me go here. You should have a website. The website should have a login page, or the website should have few members, few clients. And for this website, you will have a web server that is perfectly fine. You should configure a database server. And when you try to give some details, when you want to store some details into this database server, that server should be SQL. And you should get practice with how you can store information in that server and how to retrieve that information, what commands are used. Once, if you're comfortable with that, SQL injection will be a piece of cake for you. Right? Because you know what is happening and how a SQL server works. Without that understanding, if you proceed, probably that's going to be tough. Servers, and then we'll go for operating systems like yes, basic Linux operating system you need, and you need to understand how a Linux operating system works. Yes, we are all familiar with Windows and Linux, how basic commands works, how to install a software. I'm speaking from the scratch, right? So all these things about Linux, and then if you move on to ethical hacking, fine, you will understand a lot of different aspects in a much better way, right? Again, a simple fact, without you knowing what is a Wi-Fi modem, what is a Wi-Fi modem, how to configure Wi-Fi modem, what is SSID, what is BSSID, what is AES, TKIP, what different key terms are being used, how to configure this Wi-Fi modem. Without that, in hacking, if you learn how to hack a Wi-Fi, that again is not going to make any sense. So we have a lot of things. Once if you have done this, you have done this, you have done this, and then hacking. Now, if you appear for any interview, yes, there are more chances, more percentage of you to crack an interview. The problem now is that you complete one certification and you go for a job, and others who appear for that interview might be of higher standard. They might have a different knowledge with different domains. So you might feel difficult to crack the interview, right? But if you follow this, and that is for a non-programmer. For programmers, yes, you will be needing to know HTML, Java, and Python to start with, right? Yes, this can be the basic. So yes, after completing all this, in case if you go for interviews, you can for sure crack these interviews and identify yourself whether you are a programmer or whether you are a non-programmer, right? And after this, about the job opportunities, what we have. We have, as I told, we have so many job opportunities here. And I'll give you a few job openings which is open for freshers and others. And it comes under governance and audit. And you require less of programming skills for this. Governance and audit. You have job openings like information security audit or analyst or engineer, right? Information security audit, analyst or an engineer, which is open. You have a risk audit. You have BCP and you have DR analyst, which is open. BCP is business. Okay, business continuity planning, and DR is disaster recovery. And you can also go for security administrators. These are few jobs which comes under governance, right? Governance, audit, compliance, right? It will require you to get updated with different compliance which is available for different countries, and get yourself updated with the policies, security policies of any company, and perform audits, right? And yes, freshers, we have a lot of openings for this. And when it comes to compliance, you'll be needing to know about PCI, HIPAA, and a lot of other compliances here. And for people who are good in programming, yes, as usual, you have WAAP, and you have security pen testing engineer, pen testing and application security engineers, fine, application security engineers who keeps the apps and software safe. And if you say you are good in programming, you can opt for jobs like this. And yes, probably they are going to drill you down with questions from source code analysis and reverse engineering and a lot of different aspects from different programming languages. You should be able to handle that. And again, for non-programmers, you have infrastructure. Infrastructure, yes, we have a lot of infrastructure-based jobs. Infrastructure in the sense, I mean routers, I mean switches, firewalls, servers. So we can start with network or server security management, that is one. We have firewall security. We have threat analyst. We have IT infrastructure administrator, and you have SOC analyst. We have so many positions open for security operations center, and we also have intrusion detection analyst, right? So a lot of different things like this. I'll explain you what SOC is and how SOC can be helpful for you. SOC is a security operations center. Any global conglomerate or MNC is going to have a inbuilt SOC team, or they have a lot of different types of SOC team which can be employed. And say we'll take this company X, which has a SOC team here, and this SOC team has nearly 40 employees, and they have branches almost all over the world. And this particular branch here in India is going to manage few of those branches, right? For SOC. And in SOC, you have more levels, but here we'll talk about tier 1, tier 2, and tier 3. Right? Tier 1 is for freshers. So when you apply for a SOC analyst kind of profile, you will be working in a security operations center at tier 1 level. Tier 2, yes, probably with less experience, and this is going to be medium experience. About this, you will have a project directors who is going to oversee all what is happening. So for freshers, yes, you can target what is tier 1 and what kind of job profiles you need. You will need to work, or you will need to upgrade your knowledge with things like Splunk, which is a log analyzer, or Logrhythm, which is again a threat detector. You have to have some knowledge about playbooks or pre-configured books of what should happen. And probably a tier 1 executive will have few administrative privileges to work with a lot of playbooks like this, right? So playbook, we have so many playbooks in place. This actually happens like this. This is our company here, and one particular computer here has been infected with a malware, right? It's a malware. And yes, this computer is again interconnected with a lot of other computers here. And when this threat is being detected by one of the executives who is a tier 1 SOC analyst, right? As a fresher, he has analyzed, or he has first found this issue that a particular computer is infected with the virus. Now, he will have a particular protocol to work with. He'll know what to do, what not to do. Those protocols and those do's and don'ts will be in a SOC playlist. This can be a software which can be inbuilt or designed based on the programming needs of the company. So he might have a software like this where he needs to give the input file. He needs to take this to a sandbox environment and then analyze the file like this. And he will first go for a signature match, which he is not going to do anything. All the software is going to do, but he will escalate this to the next level. Right? If any signature match is found, then what to do? If no signature match is found, then what to do? So these are the list of things which he will be needing to know. So yes, Splunk and a lot of other tools like this, and playbooks. In case if you have good knowledge of all these things, you can very well apply for Security Operations Center. We have n number of openings for this. And as I always say, we have so many openings for cybersecurity. But we have the need for skilled professionals is still there, and we need to equip ourselves. We need to update ourselves with the needed knowledge. And yes, in case if you have the required skill set, you can for sure make a successful career in cybersecurity, right? And I wish you all the best, and you can stay in touch. I'm available on all social media. Type Shankaraj Subramanian in Google. You might get a lot of pages. I'm in social media. I interact with a lot of people in social media. I clear their doubts. And I thank everyone for your time and patience. And we'll meet in some other occasion. Thank you. Thanks a lot.